Okay. Good afternoon. Last night, a 25-year-old grown man by the name of Keon White from Baltimore non-fatally shot three teenagers in East Baltimore. He shot a 13-year-old young man, a 15-year-old young man, and a 16-year-old young lady over nonsense surrounding a neighborhood dispute. Thank God that they've survived their injuries. We worked around the clock to identify Keon White. We would not have been able to identify Keon White if that neighborhood hadn't stayed outside and interacted with patrol officers and detectives. We were able to develop a suspect vehicle description last night. Baltimore patrol officers hunted down that vehicle, found it, got detectives involved, and we identified the owner of that vehicle as Keon White, and our victims identified him as the shooter. He was placed under arrest. This worked as it should work. These senseless shootings shouldn't happen, but when they do happen, our community needs to know that we can't close them as quickly as we did last night without their cooperation. So thumbs up from the BPD to the community for working with us to close this case. We really profoundly appreciate the cooperation that we got last night in East Baltimore. Any questions about this?
Commissioner, can you be a little specific in how you were able to track down Mr. White?
Well, we're going to hand out copies of the statement of probable cause. Obviously, when we deal with community members who come forward and give us information about crimes, we protect that to the degree that we can while still seeking to establish probable cause. But they pointed us in the direction of a particular house last night where we thought our shooter may have run into. That's why you saw the SWAT team out there last night. He wasn't in there, but we found him not too far away after we found his car, after we identified him as the owner of the car, and then after detectives and patrol officers found him nearby. So we detained him, we identified him, and we prepared photo spreads for our victims to look at, and they identified him in those photo spreads, and we've since charged him with multiple crimes for shooting these three young people.
Neighborhood dispute, is that what you said? What kind of dispute where you go out and shoot three teenagers? What was the
dispute? I don't think there's a dispute that would ever justify shooting three teenagers. This guy's a 25-year-old man, so it's disgusting. It was a dispute that surrounded a fight between two females that happened earlier. No more complicated than that, and unfortunately he accessed a firearm and he chose to shoot these three kids.
How are the teenagers doing, the victims?
They're fine. I'm not sure if they've all been released yet, but thankfully non-fatal gunshot wounds, and they're all going to be just fine.
Was he shooting at them, or did they just happen to take the bullet?
He intentionally shot them.
Commissioner, following up on my colleague's question, earlier reports indicated that the kids were perhaps not the intended targets. Are you saying now that they were the intended targets, the kids?
They were the intended targets. I'm not sure if he intended to shoot other people as well, but he intended to shoot these three kids, and he in fact shot them.
What were the circumstances? We're told, we went out there were some witnesses who said that there were a bunch of people, maybe 100 people, out on the block. Can you describe the scene in which it happened?
Well, I mean, Keith, you were out there last night. I saw you out there. It was a beautiful summer night, unseasonably cool for July. And there's a lot of people out right now at this time of year in Baltimore. And they should be able to be out, and they should be able to interact with each other and their neighbors without worrying about a verbal dispute turning into someone choosing to introduce a firearm. So that's what Keon White did last night. That's not acceptable. The community knows who did it, and they stepped up, told us who did it, and we found them and locked them up.
How soon will the suspects see a commissioner, or how long will the, let me back up, when will the bill be set, or when will the hearing for bill be taken place?
I'm not sure of those details, if in fact they've taken place already.
Maybe 24 hours.
It could be up to 24 hours.
The brother of the girl who was shot, the 16-year-old, said that she had been trying to break up a fight at the time she was shot. Was that a separate fight? I mean, maybe this is a question for the commissioner.
Yeah.
step up, Dennis, and correct me. So basically what we know is there was a dispute in the neighborhood between appears to be neighbors. That dispute escalated where more individuals came to the aid of their loved ones to include these kids. As a result of that, it escalated to where our individual or suspect shot into that crowd to include those three children to disrupt that incident.
And you said you're not sure what that fight was over, whether it was just you said between two women, but about what?
It's a senseless acts, stuff that is really irrelevant. And that's the gist of this. The nature of this incident was simply a very minuscule dispute that was irrelevant, and absolutely no gunplay should come into a neighborhood dispute like that.
Do you know what kind of gun it was, and can you say how we got a hold of it at this time?
I'm sorry?
You know what kind of gun it was?
We do have ballistic evidence on the scene, but again, you know, as this investigation continues, we're not going to disclose that at this time.
Can we say it's a handgun?
Yes.
Okay. You said he ran into a home. Did he actually live on the block?
He uses an address around the corner from this location in close proximity. He uses other addresses, but we do know that this was an address through our investigation that he uses in frequency. So again, just to recap, based on the community support and cooperation, coupled with great investigations from our detectives and mobile operations from our patrol unit, we also use some closed circuit television camera footage that assisted. All that combined brought this case to closure very quickly.
Major, the closed circuit television footage, how did that help? Did it show, Mr. White?
It was able to corroborate some of the evidence that we were getting from the community.
I know we'll probably get a handout in just a moment, but he faces several charges. Does it include attempted murder?
Yes.
Okay. Do you guys go back and look and see if you're able to connect him with other stuff or the weapon?
Absolutely. Oh, yes. Mm-hmm.
It sounds like he was picked up before. What was his criminal past like, if that's the case?
All that will be forwarded after the fact. Once you guys are supplied with a statement of probable cause, the warrant, you'll have the full background as well. We will say that the Incident Command War Room played a role in this also to help disseminate that information very quickly back and forth between the intelligence that was coming in and to the detectives and officers that were actively investigating on the ground.
And in the other triple shooting or the other shooting that happened last night, any developments in
that? Yes, there are developments. It's not going as quickly as this one did. Again, we would ask that the community also cooperate in that case. We know that there were several individuals out at the time, similar to the individuals were out in East Baltimore. So we do need additional information on that case. We have a good focus point in that investigation right now, but we really do need the community to step up and help us with that.
Major, police have said on several occasions, you guys can't do your jobs effectively catching the bad guys with guns without the community stepping up. There have been many shootings in Baltimore City where the community does not step up. Why do you think they did in this particular case?
I can't speak for the community, but I would hope that they're fed up as much as we are. You know, we encourage the community to be out and enjoying these beautiful nights as we had last night. You know, that's what Baltimore is about. Baltimore is enjoying, you know, people out on their streets, sitting on their marble steps, cooking out and enjoying beautiful summer nights, eating some steamed crabs. And I hope they are fed up.
Any more questions?
Thank you, Commissioner. Thank
Thanks.
So we'll have some handouts for everyone. I also want to give you the Metro Crime Stoppers number again, just if you want to take it down. It's 1-866-7-LOCKUP.